In the previous video, we created a simple access database. The database contained two tables. One table was the authors table that contained the last name and first name of authors. The second table was the books table that contained the titles of books, the year they were published, and the author ID field, which identified author record for the author that wrote the book. This allowed us to list books without duplicating information. An author could write more than one book, but their name only appeared in the database a single time. The books table contained the author IDs for each author for the books that they had written. Quickly run into a problem with our database if we try to add a book that has two authors. First, I'll add the authors. Now, if I try to add both of those authors to one book, I only have the ability to put in one author ID. I have no way of putting more than one author ID in the author ID field. So this means I have to re-examine the way my database is built. You will notice the one-to-many relationship that exists between authors and books. This means that one author can write many books, but it does not mean that a book can have many authors. One way of solving this problem is creating a third database table that acts as an association table. In our original example, we have a primary key in the authors table that is related to a foreign key called author ID in the books table. In our modified database, we will have an association table that consists of foreign keys that relate back to both tables. Now what I will do is I will delete the relationship between the authors and books table by right-clicking on the relationship and selecting Delete. I answer the dialog box that asks me if I wish to permanently delete the relationship. Now the tables are no longer related to each other. I'm going to edit the books table in Design View, and I'm going to delete the author ID field by right-clicking on the blue area to the left of the field name and selecting Delete. Again, I'm going to click on Yes, but notice also this time it's deleting the data that resides in those fields as well. Before doing something like this, I should make sure that I have the data somewhere else. It's also asking me if I'm sure I want to do this because Access will delete one or more indexes. An index is a way of quickly finding a record in a table. I'm going to click Yes to this as well. Now that I've deleted both the relationship and the author ID foreign key in the books table, I'm going to close my tables. I'm going to create a new table by going to the Create ribbon and clicking on Table. I'm going to go to Design View for this table. I'm going to call the table Authored. I'm going to create an author ID field, making sure that the data type is number. I'm going to create a book ID field, making sure the data type is number. And then I will close my table, saving the changes. I'm now going to go back to Database Tools, Relationships, and I'll click on the Show Table icon in the Relationship Tools Design ribbon and make sure that the Authored table is added. I may want to click and drag my tables around to reorganize them so it is clear to me what I am doing. I'm going to drag the Author ID field from the Authored table to the ID field in the Authors table, and I'm going to enforce referential integrity. Notice that the relationship type is one to many between the author's ID field and the authored author ID field, and I'll click on Create. Then I will drag the book ID field in the authored table to the ID field in the books table, again checking the boxes for referential integrity, and again noticing that it's a one-to-many relationship, and I will click on Create. Now I can see that an author can have many authored records, but an authored record can only have one author's record. I can see that a book can have many authored records, but a single authored record can only have one book. I'm going to close out of the relationships window, saving my changes, and I'm going to open the authored table, and I'm going to begin entering my foreign keys. I may wish to go back to my tables to double check my work. Now, when I get to the new book that I entered that had multiple authors, I can add two records with the same book ID, and there's nothing restricting me from doing that. Notice that both of these records with the same book ID have different author IDs to reflect the two authors that wrote that book. If I want to see the results of my data, I can create a query. First, I'm going to close the tables that I have opened, and I'll go to the Create ribbon and click on Query Design. I'm going to use the Control key to select all of my tables, and I will click on Add. I can then click on Close. Even though my tables are jumbled, I can still move them around so that it is a little clearer what is happening. I'll drag down the information that I want to query. Notice that I do not have to query on the foreign keys in the authored table, but because they exist, my query will work, showing me all of the authors. I will click on the Run button to run my query, and it shows me all of the authors that are in my database, as well as the same book that's authored by two different authors. Remember that this book only appears once in the books table, and it's because of my query that it's appearing twice when I query it, because it's coming back for each author that's listed as authoring that book. A common mistake when querying multiple tables is neglecting to include the table in your query that's creating the association. I'm going to edit my query and go back into Design View. Watch what happens when I remove the authored table from my query. Notice that there's no longer an indication of a relationship between the books and authors table. And notice that when I now run my query, I get what is called a Cartesian product. It's every possible combination of book and author. This is inaccurate, and it's happening because the query does not know about the relationship. So if this happens, I need to make sure that I'm including the table that contains the relationship between these two tables that are otherwise unrelated. Once I include that table, when I run my query, I see the results that I expect.